This 3D printed VTOL could fly 130 miles, which would make it one of the longest range in the world. I designed, built, and flew it in only 90 days after crashing over and over. I started this project with a sketch and almost no experience doing CAD, 3D printing, or modeling aerodynamics. See, I want to build eVTOLs for personal use, and I was determined. Mission profile, maximize flight time. I modeled the airframe, designed it in CAD, and then sliced and printed over 100 foaming PLA and PETG test parts. I got to work assembling and testing the components. Then it was time to hover test. It crashed. Again and again. After 2 weeks of troubleshooting, I finally realized the issue was overheating ESCs. So I rebuilt the airframe, upgraded the ESC motors and wiring, and bench tested again. I made a thrust test stand and it worked. The ESCs were now running cooler, ready for more hover testing. The first stable hover was great. After a quick tune, pitch, roll, and yaw were all dialed in. So I prepared for the main event, testing the transition from hover to fixed wing flight. Was my VTOL ready? As I was ready to test the transition, I was nervous. But the cruise propeller started generating thrust. It was actually wing-borne. The transition back to hover was smooth. The cruise motor shuts off and the lifting motors take over. I was relieved it did not crash and thrilled it worked. One more thing. My flight testing shows my VTOL could fly for about 130 miles or 3 hours. Even unoptimized, this would be one of the longest range 3D printed VTOLs ever made. How did I achieve this with almost no experience? High energy density battery, aero modeling for better L over D, improving efficiency in cruise, like switching from this 3-blade 7-inch prop to this 2-blade 7-inch prop. Like and subscribe if you want to see my next project towards building an eVTOL for personal use. Thanks for watching.